Hey everyone, it's T-Berry here, and I kind of wanted to make this little tutorial on how to make this cool little cute realistic worn out movie ticket. I was making my friend, a friend of a friend's YouTube layout, and he does movie reviews, so I was like, alright, I'll try to figure out, and I found this really cute tutorial. The only bad thing is it's only text, and some people hate reading things, or they don't understand when they're reading it, so I'm going to do a quick, video or tutorial of this tutorial, and I'll put a URL in the info, and you can come to it and read it if you don't like my video, basically. On this page you'll find out some brushes you can use and some textures which you would be using in this tutorial. I'll probably just link the brushes and the textures and all that in the info. So let's get started. Okay, so you're going to open up Photoshop, and you're going to open up a new thing, and you're going to put in 400 by 300, and the resolution by 300 to make it look really crisp. And you're gonna, I should just put the background color something kind of bright and not dull, because in the tutorial it says use a wood background. I don't like using it. I like to use colors as my backgrounds. I do that when I paint too, on Photoshop and Paint Tools Fi. So basically just color the background a bright color. And do a new layer and get a rectangular marquee tool and draw it out about right. Let's move. Oh, you can also hold spacebar down to move it around about right here. And you're going to go to, you're going to go to your gradient tool, and you're going to make a gradient with these two colors, DD9800, and that's the beginning of it, and the end of the gradient is going to be A97200, and you're going to go right in the middle of it, and I would suggest hold down shift and bring it down about right here. And make it from a light to a dark gradient. That would be the basis of your ticket. So make a new layer and go to deselect and take this circular marquee tool and hold shift and draw it about a circle about this big. You can also again hold spacebar and kind of place it where you want to place it. Put that there and take a bucket, take the paint tool bucket, and paint it black, basically, and deselect. And basically make copies. Duplicate layer. Duplicate it about three times, technically, so you have four of the layer. And take the move, and basically move it to every corner of the piece. There you go. And select all these layers, like holding shift and then merge them and press select, and you can just delete this layer now, and then on this layer press delete, and voila, you made the end of the tickets. So you deselect. Alright, next you can do the perforated edges, like the edges that you take. So you go into your eraser, and I think I have the brush pre-made. Yeah, I do. Open it up. You're going to make you're going to make a brush that's 3 pixels and it's 161, and that's the spacing, and that's all you do to the brush. And when you're doing the brush, zoom in a little bit, you're going to go to the edge and you're going to click, and you're going to hold shift, and you're going to click right above it, and you can do that again. Wait, no, that looks gross. Basically, you hold that And you hold shift. And you do that. And do it again. Let's see what that looks like. This one might take a while to do, so you make sure you do it correctly. Because you kind of want to make it look kind of neat. There you go. There's one, and you do it to the other side. Remember, hold shift to make it a straight line. And voila. There is the perforated edges, or the terrible edges, I guess. I don't know what the name of it is. So you're going to make a new layer, and you're going to go to, there is nothing. You're going to download this texture. I'll put in the info. And this is basically just going to give it a nice texture of it. And you're going to go here, and I basically don't save the image, I just paste it in here. I also make the image a little bit smaller, because it's this big, so I just hold shift and bring it down, and not bring the thing that makes it move, bring it, and you're going to put the opacity to 48, or 49, I would say 48, and you might want to make it a little bit bigger. Oh, nope, did not want to do that. Oh, nope. I am actually warping it. I keep pressing control instead of shift. If you press control, it'll transform it. And you're going to take that away, and you're just going to make it a little bit bigger. And you're just going to change the opacity to 48. And that looks okay. And there you go. And yeah, it looks fine. And then so you're going to press control, hit the ticket, and you're going to invert it. And you're going to delete all the rest of it. And then deselect. So basically, you have your ticket now. One thing is to add a back shadow, or drop shadow. So basically, go to drop shadow, and then you're going to keep everything the same except this. You're going to change this to a 2, and you're going to change this to a 10. And everything else is the same, and there you go. Little backdrop now. Alright, next thing is open a new layer. I would suggest press control again, the ticket shape, layer 1. And you're going to add dirt to it to make it look grungy and nasty. I would use this color, 906A39. It's a good dirt color, and I would suggest using some grunge brushes. You can use any type of grunge brushes. I'll link the ones I am using for this one. And make them a little bit smaller. And so you put a little bit there, and you just change it up a bit. Just make them a little bit smooth. You make this one a little bit bigger, and see, the reason why it's like not coming out the ticket, which I like, is because I selected it, so it won't come out the ticket. And here's like a spongy kind of. That looks kind of gross. Let's see if I can fix that one. Yeah. And there you go. That's the next layer. I open up a new layer. And you're going to go back. And you're going to get this green folded paper. It makes it look like it's folded and it's been in your pocket for a while. And paste it. And one thing about this image is it's really big. So if you're change it to luminosity, because that's what you're gonna be using it on. And so you can see the ticket. So you can figure out where you want to put it. So you can put it like up here or right here or right here. However you want it. I would put mine kind of like not in the center. If you want to use like basic art stuff that you learn in like first year of art. And then I would take that and I would start erasing. So So I would pick a pretty big brush at first, and it's pretty not a hard brush. And start erasing it from here, so you get everything. So when you let's say you're using this for another file and you're just making it in this file, you wouldn't. Oh, I think I still have this on that weird brush, don't I? Yep, I still do have it on that weird brush. Choose like a normal brush, and there you go. On that weird brush. And just start erasing everything away, because you will get like a, again, if you transfer it to another file, you'll kind of get that green paper overlaying over it, and you could just erase it again in that file if you want to, but it's easier if you just do this, and you kind of like erase it, and you kind of make it go like this, and kind of, so it still has like, see, it still has the tear, so it looks like it's been folded and it's been kept in someone's pocket. I think there's another sheet of paper one you can use. There's a pink one, but I like the green one because it looks like it's, you just folded it a little bit in your pocket. So you leave it like that, and you select. Open up a new layer, and this is where you're going to make like the content. You can, I would suggest maybe putting this in a folder and just naming the folder content. I don't know how you spell things. I'm really bad at spelling, basically. Oh, no, I don't want to change the layer style for the folder. And start a new layer in it. And you're basically going to take a rounded marquee tool, and you're going to make the size to a 10 point. And draw it, and shift. Kind of make it in the middle. That looks good. You're basically going to select it. You can delete the round rectangle. You don't need that anymore. You're going to go to edit. You're going to, make a new layer. Make a new layer, then go to edit, then go to stroke. Then make it a 3 and make it this color. Well, no, actually make it this color. It's 4D3011. And it's a dark color, and you're going to put on the, I'm going to put center. No, inside, actually. Inside of the marquee. And press OK, and make it 3 pixels, and deselect, and voila, there's the beginning of the content. Next, you're going to make the little areas where the numbers are going to go into, so you're going to get your brush tool, make it up to 3 pixels, and basically, when you draw it, so find where you want it, so you're going to put it there, and hold shift, and just drag down. And if you're me and you're kind of bad at kind of making things match, I would suggest taking the lasso tool and kind of like lassoing around this bar. It'll only copy the bar. Copy it and then paste. So you're going to paste it again, and you're just going to drag this over. And you're going to get a kind of guess where it goes. Yeah, that's about right. And basically select these two layers and then merge layers. So it's one complete layer. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to take your text tool. If it will go to my text tool. And basically, you're going to type in 6 random numbers. So basically, I would just look at my keyboard and count the 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're going to take this. You're going to take it. And you're going to make it Times New Roman. And you're going to make the color this red color right here. It's 601301, and I just like, it's a rich red color, and it's kind of old, worn red looking, and you're basically going to take it, and you're gonna turn it, and I like how Photoshop CS 6 has that little number thing that gauges, like, how far have you turned it. It might be off, like 0.1, but that's fine. And hold shift to make the size of it stay about the same when you're making it smaller. And shift and drag.
User in your channel timed out.
Okay. Something. And make it a little bit bigger. And kind of try it out. Let's see. That looks about right. So basically, you're going to take that and you're just going to copy it. Again, hold shift, drag it over. And you're just going to take it and you're going to flip it this way. Or you can come in here. I forgot, you can do this. Type in 180. And you're going to maybe bring this over a little bit. Let me fix this one, by the way, because I'm going to get mad now if I can't. Yeah, that's fine now. And, there you go. There's the numbers. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to get your text tool again. And again, if I'm kind of bad at typing right now, so you can put admit. Oh, all in capital letters too. Admit 1, all in capital letters, and change the color to black, and make it center. And you're going to make the text into Helvetica. Bold, I think? Yeah, no. Here is it. Yeah, I thought I put it in here. Oh, wait, no, this is C. Helvetica. There it is. Helvetica Bold. And you're just going to bring it down to whatever size it is. To me, it looks a little weird. Maybe because I did not make it black. That would explain a lot of it. To make it black. And you might want to make it a little bit bigger. And kind of place it in the center. I think I spelled that wrong. Let me do it. Oh, yep. Spelled wrong. I knew something was weird. I was like, that doesn't look great. There we go. I spelled it wrong. Oopsie doopsie. So just place it in the middle, and you might want to go to your text box and kind of put it. I would put it on 8. Wait, I would call it just that. 8, and down more, and that looks about right. And so after this, everything in this content folder you can like close, and I would suggest giving this a masking tool. And when you're doing using a mask like layer, make sure your foreground brush is a black and your background color is a white. And again, take the grungy brushes and kind of giving it like the text of it's a little worn down. You can bring it down a bit. It kind of makes it look old and kind of worn. I would suggest using this because, let's say, if you use too much of it, you can go back through it and fix it. And basically, that's it. This is how you make your own little personal ticket you can use for any project that you need. Sorry if you hear a sound in the background. And that's about it. Thank you guys for watching. Rate, comment, not rate, thumbs up, comment, and subscribe, and thank you for watching. If you have any more tutorials you'd like to learn, or if you want to know how to do something in Photoshop, just message me or leave a comment on this video. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.